Busty Louise Redknapp ditches her wedding ring for the first time since divorcing husband Jamie as she seriously lets her hair down for energetic GAY performance on NAI. On Friday, she ended her 19-year marriage to former footballer Jamie Redknapp in a 25-second court hearing. And Louise Redknapp showed the crowds at GAY on New Year's Eve that she's now happily unattached, as she took to the stage to sing, dance and laugh her way into 2018. The mother of two appeared not to have a care in the world as she put on an energetic performance, notably without her wedding ring on, before roaring with laughter as the clock struck midnight, bidding farewell to what has been a tricky year for the former Eternal star. This comes after the Mirror reported that the 43-year-old was really excited to celebrate with pals out on the town. It's the first time she's ever done anything like this. Louise, 43, look typically chic in an all-black ensemble consisting of a skirt and jacket suit, black tights and thigh-high leather boots. Literally letting her hair down, the singer wore her chestnut locks loosely around her shoulders in light waves, and displayed a flawless complexion, showing off a healthy golden glow. She added nude gloss to her lips and a smoky swish of shadowing to her eyes. The songstress performance took place after midnight, at 2:30 a.m. in fact. Yet Louise had energy to spare as she sang her set with a smile on her face. Her lack of ring seemed to confirm that Louise has finally declared herself single, having kept it on over the last year, despite her reportedly filing for divorce 9 months ago. She was joined by former Strictly Come Dancing partner Kevin Clifton, 35, who has been supporting her in the wake of her marriage split and choreographed her stage show. It was previously claimed Kevin's wife Karen, 35, had told Louise's husband Jamie to keep her away from her beau when the footballer allegedly rang her with concerns over Louise's close relationship with Kevin. Sources claim the Strictly Come Dancing professional had been very upset at the time of the call and had told Jamie to try and keep Louise away from Kevin, accusing the singer of ruining her marriage. After becoming aware of Louise texting Kevin, Jamie reportedly decided to reach out to Karen, with the source claiming he made the decision to call Karen without Louise's knowledge, which was a very hard thing for him to do. He asked Karen if he thought their partners were having an affair. Karen was very upset at the time, and that's when she asked Jamie to try and keep Louise away from Kevin. The source added that emotions had been running high, while another source deemed close to Louise claimed the naked singer had been left furious by husband Jamie's actions, as she had been friends with Karen and the accusations had made things between them unnecessarily uncomfortable. Louise's partying has come into question since news of a split surfaced, as it was claimed in July that her friendship with party girl Daisy Lowe contributed to the split, as the 27-year-old helped the star rediscover her youth ahead of the appearance. Sources continued, she's booked to perform some of her solo hits at GAY nightclub in London in front of friends. They plan to have a drink on the VIP gallery and enjoy the atmosphere and then hit up some other venues. She's really going to let her hair down and celebrate the new year, truly meaning the start of a new chapter for her. Louise was seen living it up with pals on Thursday evening as she attended the wedding of Strictly Come Dancing's artistic director and choreographer Jason Gilkison in Liverpool, just hours before the court hearing. News of her plans comes after it was claimed Louise reportedly filed for divorce from husband Jamie in March. Insiders tell The Sun, she filed for divorce from the footballer 9 months ago, just weeks after the end of the Strictly Come Dancing tour. Her part on the show has been widely reported to have contributed to the split. A source told the publication after the hearing, the marriage was over long before anyone previously believed. Louise and Jamie were first hit with reports of marital woes in April, however insiders claim by this point she had already begun legal proceedings. The final dates on the tour were 11th and 12th February at London's The O2 Arena, just weeks before the alleged submission date in March. Her participation in 2016 as Strictly Come Dancing was widely regarded to have been a factor in the split, but it has been claimed that Jamie fully supported her decision to take part and encouraged her at each Saturday night show. Jamie's unreasonable behavior has been cited as the cause of the split, a reason he did not contest. However, it has now been claimed the former footballer is unhappy with being solely blamed for their divorce, reports The Sun. It was reported that Jamie was upset at claims the 19-year marriage had ended due to Louise pursuing her own career interest, as he had allegedly been single-handedly caring for their two sons, Charlie, 13, and Beau, 9, For a year. A source told the website that Jamie wanted to get the divorce process over and done with but said, Jamie is not happy. He is blamed for the marriage ending by preventing her pursuing her career. She did loads of things when they were married and he never stood in her way. The source added that due to her commitments on Strictly, Cabaret and her solo tour, Louise hadn't been around much. And added, for the past year he has practically looked after their two sons single-handedly. This comes hours after Louise and Jamie were awarded a decree nisi in a hearing that is said to have lasted a mere 25 seconds. The glamorous showbiz couple first confirmed their split 2 months ago, with Louise revealing she had moved out of the family home in October. In a 25-second hearing at London's Central Family Court, District Judge Ian Mulcas pronounced the decree nisi. During the court finding, it was announced the reason for their divorce lay with Jamie's unreasonable behavior. The judge held that the respondent Jamie had behaved in such a way that the petitioner Louise cannot reasonably be expected to live with the respondent. It was announced, the petitioner has sufficiently proved the contents of the petition herein and is entitled to a decree of divorce, the marriage having irretrievably broken down. The facts found proved being the respondent's unreasonable behavior. Jamie did not contest the findings and it was concluded that the marriage had broken down irretrievably and would be dissolved in 6 weeks, giving they reached amicable terms on custody of their two sons. Louise previously spoke of loving her amazing partner but admitted she felt like a sort of stepford wife who is coming back to who I really am. She stepped back into the spotlight on last year's Strictly Come Dancing, but was hit by claims that she was getting too close to her partner Kevin Clifton, whose marriage to fellow dancer Karen Clifton also appears to be in trouble. There have been reports that Karen, who is reportedly dating a new man, telephoned Jamie to warn the former footballer of Louise's close friendship with her husband. Louise is relaunching her pop career and is touring for the first time in 15 years, with Kevin recently seen supporting her at one of her gigs. Recently, Louise said she loved her amazing partner Jamie, with whom she has two children, although she had come to feel like a sort of stepford wife and she was coming back to who I really am. Yet their marriage could not be saved. The decree nisi for L.E. Redknapp v. J.F. Redknapp was pronounced before a judge on Friday. A decree absolute ending the marriage can be issued after 6 weeks, should no objections be formally made.